What's up, guys? It's me, Dolphinatic, and welcome to the very last PPL match of the season for the Tottenham Hotspur. Now, next season, we are going under some rebranding changes. We will emerge as the Norwich Skitty next season. Now, however silly that sounds, I know Skitty's stupid, but Norwich is my team. I've got to do it for the boys. Anyway, we are facing Slyroh today. Our game is pretty much a nothing game. However, if I win, I can still finish like 8th. So there is meaning in this battle, I guess. If I win by 4 or more, I overtake Sly. If I win, I finish below Sly, but overtake everyone else. And if I lose, then I can come last. I just need, if Troy doesn't win, it's fine. Or Tito. So there's no relegation, so it doesn't really matter to me at this point. It's been a learning curve for me. I know what to draft next time and what not to draft next time. Anyway, quickly look over the team. We have Mega Zam with Psychic Focus Blast. That combo itself does lots of damage to Sly's team. Knock Off to try and catch the Gliscor off guard. And the Substitute to try and dodge any Sucker Punch shenanigans from a stupid Drapion. I've seen his team because we've tried to battle twice already, but I was bringing an illegal mon apparently. Apparently it's my Empoleon. I regen the exact same thing and it worked this time, so I don't know. Next up we have Durant. Durant is going to do some work. Iron Head, Stone Edge, Aerial Ace, Protect. This thing's going to be an absolute monster this battle because it hits pretty much everything super effective with a combo of these moves. It's going to be brilliant. Aerial Ace one-shots or has like a 80% chance to one-shot Medicham without rocks, and I do outspeed. So there's going to be fun with this ant today. Next is Cress. This thing's just bulky as hell, and you know it does things. Toxic, Moonlight, Moonblast, Ice Beam. Moonblast is the only thing it really has to hit Drapion, which I know he's bringing now, but I was pretty confident because it's a dark type. I have Mega Zam and Cress. Like, why would you not bring one? So it's going to be important for me to knock off his item. He'll either have Leftovers or Assault Vest, I reckon. Probably Leftovers so he can set up some Swords Dance. But then I have this thing to stop it. Terrakion, Choice Band, Close Combat, gone. I think it's like it's almost a guaranteed one-shot, but with Rocks it is a guaranteed one-shot. If he wants to knock off my Choice Band, that's absolutely fine. He might have Aerial Ace, but I will outspeed if he's not Scarfed. Next up is Raikou. Now, I've changed this because I thought this was the Hacktmon, but it turns out it's not. But I'm quite impressed by it anyway. So, I have Thunderbolt, Volt Switch, Hidden Power, Ice, and Bulldoze. That's right, Bulldoze, ladies and gentlemen, to hit that Drapion. Now, I'm sure Thunderbolt will probably do more, but I have got the Expert Belt. I was originally Rash Choice Scarf with Aura Sphere for Kyurem, but now I know I don't actually need that because, he has got Kyurem on his team. But Aura Sphere wouldn't have really helped too much. Bulldoze can help a bit, because obviously speed and stuff. And then I have Empoleon, which was the problem child for some reason, but this thing's bulky as hell. I need it for Kyurem. Obviously, Earth Power's a thing, but Earth Power won't be doing much anyway. So that thing's there with Roar as well to be a phaser. Scald for Burns, Flash Cannon to hit that stupid pesky dragon super effectively. Anyway, Slyroh, I can finally battle you. We've been trying for like 45 minutes. I did warn him beforehand that I might have a dodgy poke, but it turns out it was the wrong poke I thought it would be. Anyway, Sly, you better accept this challenge invite, dude. I have to win this to end the season on a high. 4-7, not a 3-8. Come on, please. That's just embarrassing. At least 4-7 is slightly more respectable. It's my first time in a league. I never watched the GBA or anything before I did this league. Now I watch it like an avid fan. I love it. We'll go with this team. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to Season 2, even though Season 1 hasn't finished, but it is about to finish. Right, there's the team. Arcanine, Gliscor, I did start writing it down. Kyurem, Gliscor was the one. Gliscor was the one. Right then, what do we lead with? He hasn't got a spinner, unless he has Defog on his Gliscor, which means he wouldn't have Poison Heal. I think that's how it works. Honestly tempted to lead off with Bug, but I'm not sure. Let's lead off with Raikou, because Raikou is Bay. And if he wants to lead off with Medicham, then it's straight switch into Cresselia. So Sly, thank you for being in PPL, dude. Good luck, have fun. So what is he going to lead with? Please be... Rotom would be a nice lead for him, and I can hit him, you know, neutrally. Fisticuffs. So that is Medicham. Interesting. He will only outspeed me with Fake Out. Bullet Punch won't do much, so... I mean, this thing does get Thief, I think? It won't do much to Cress anyway. I'm going to click Volt Switch, because if he wants to Fake Out, that's fine. I'll outspeed him on the next turn, because I am max speed. Oh, I am hasty, though, I just realized, which is obviously negative defense. So is he going to go for that Fake Out? Is he going to predict my first turn switch? He does go for the Fake Out. How much is this going to do? Obviously, Mega Cham is powerful. Jesus Christ, that done a lot. That done a lot. Now what's he going to do? Let's Volt Switch out of here. He could just go straight into his Gliscor. Obviously, Hidden Power Ice. I should have clicked Hidden Power Ice. I should have been real. But he doesn't want to stay in now, because he will take huge damage. He's probably expecting me Choice Specs. So actually, I'm going to go for Hidden Power Ice on the next turn. If it means Raikou dies, it means Raikou dies. So he does withdraw. Does he go into Gliscor? Hipster Entei. He goes into Arcanine, which is cool, actually. Works for me. That really does work for me. So the Volt Switch. So he's specially defensive Arcanine. Definitely. So he has Drapion, Kyurem, Gliscor, Megacham, Arcanine, Rotom. Absolutely no reason for me not to go. I could get my rocks up. Could get my rocks up for free here. Yeah, no, I could go into Terrakion and fire off a Stone Edge and just two-shot something. But I'm going to go into Empoleon and set up rocks. He could have the Close Combat and or Wild Charge. He is defensive, though. He's got Leftovers. That's fine. So, let's go for the Stealth Rock. He won't want to take a Scald. He has to keep this thing around for Mega Zam. So, I'm getting my rocks up. Rocks are nice, indeed. So I'm quite happy with how it started. I'm glad I traded that off, really. And I'm glad I've also managed to keep him thinking that I'm choice. So he does withdraw, which is cool. I'm going to go straight for my Stealth Rocks. He does go into this thing. But I don't mind if he goes into that. He could sub. But, he can't touch Cress still. So let's go into Cress. He might click Drain Punch. Not really sure yet what he will do. What are you going to do here? Drain Punch. He does Drain Punch. So I'm expecting him to want to go into his Drapion next turn. I'm expecting it. But, I can't risk going into Terrakion just yet, let's click Moonblast. I'm sure he'll go into Drapion here. I'm sure of it. He is thinking. He withdraws. So, as long as Cress is around, Mega Cham is not a problem. Bunby. There's a Drapion. Should have gone into Terrakion. Should have been real. So, go for the Moonblast. See if he's, Leftovers. He is Leftovers, which is cool. So what will you go for? You can go for Swords Dance. He'll go for a knockoff here, so I'm going to go straight into Terrakion. And before he reveals, he has Aerial Ace. Terrakion here. He might even go for like a... If he goes for Swords Dance, that's fine too, because I will outspeed. Give me your knockoff damage. Give me your yummy, yummy... We get to the sub. Ooh, that's interesting. How about no? How about that's not nice? He might have Earthquake. So I'm going to have to hit the Stone Edge here. Because I can't risk the defense drops. Right, I hit the Stone Edge, which is nice. Now, another Stone Edge might kill. What will he go for here? Aerial Ace? Earthquake? Earthquake. There's the Earthquake. Can we live? We should be able to, surely. Yeah, cheers, Terrakion. Right, I am banded, So if he wants to go into Gliscor here, that's fine. I'm going to stay in and go for another Stone Edge. There's no reason for me not to. I just have to keep this thing out from behind a sub. I have got Roar Empoleon. Just in case. But I doubt an Earthquake will be taking me out. Actually, it'll probably do slightly less than what it done to this Terrakion. He knows something's going to get hurt here. And he can't let this thing die. So what's he got? He has, I mean, Gliscor is a switch. It'll do about 60% max. With rocks, it will Oko. It will two hit KO. I think it's got like a 2% chance of him living. So, I mean, he hasn't actually got a safe switch other than this thing. So if I can get a crit, that would be lovely. Oh, I do hit, which is a good start. High crit chance, anyone? Ooh, okay. He's leftovers. He has got defog on this thing, so I'm going to stay in and go for another Stone Edge. Because I naturally outspeed this thing. And he is in deep, deep trouble right now. Hit. Oh, no! Oh, he roosts. Okay, that's interesting. He roosts. So he's going to get his rocks up this turn, I reckon. So Cress, we're going to Cress. He'll probably have the knockoff. So he's not toxic because I can toxic this thing. I can freely click toxic now. Default, there it is. Might go into Drapion again here. Which is slightly scary, honestly. Let's click toxic. I'm going to be ballsy. He might set up his rocks here. Or knock off. The temptation is real, surely. But he might stick to his game plan and go into Drapion, which is what he needs to do, really. So Toxic was a silly play. Don't go out into your thing. Hipster Entei. Sweet! I'll take that all day, every day, thank you. Toxic, so what will you do to me? What can you do? You can Will-O-Wisp me. Your leftovers. So Will-O-Wisp, Morning Sun, Flare Blitz, and something else. And I don't have Chandelure, which is a shame. Real shame. So I'm going to go straight into Empoleon. He might pull a double here. I switch first, and I assume I'm slower than this thing. So we'll see what he does. He could go for a close combat or a wild charge. Toxic. Sweet. He wants a Toxic Cress, which is not cool. So this time, instead of clicking Stealth Rocks, I am going to just click Scald. So he's got Toxic, probably Morning Sun. Let's click Scald. Nothing on his team will take a Scald nicely. I don't think. What's his team? Gliscor, Kyurem, Drapion, Megacham, Arcanine, Rotom. So actually, his only switch here is Kyurem, but then I have Flash Cannon. Here's Death Wish. He said he was ready for this thing as well. Withdraws. Can I get the burn on something, please? Fisticuffs. Oh, please burn. Please get the burn. Ooh. Oh, no burn. Okay. So the Cress switch is obvious, but I make that play. It's all I can do. Could start bulking up if he wants. Drain Punch. Okay. Does the exact same damage as it done before. Right, he still can't touch me. So I might switch into Raikou. Knowing Raikou is my least expendable, is the most expendable member of my team. And that way I can keep momentum if he wants to switch. He can't keep this thing in. He needs it. He needs it from Polian too much. He can't risk me clicking Moonblast. So if I go into Raikou, I can just whack off a bulldoze on that thingy of his. So he's got Gliscor, Kyurem, Drapion, Megacham, Arcanine, Rotom. This is intense so far. Really intense. He's really thinking about it here. Come on, man. Drapion. You have a free switch into Drapion when Cress is out. He withdraws. Perfect. That means I can go into Raikou. Perfect. I wish I had gone into Terrakion because I could have clicked Stone Edge again. Or Close Combat even. So actually, he might switch into Arcanine here. Because Arcanine is his designated wall. So let's click Bulldoze. Because I do have the Hidden Power Ice. So he might predict me to go for Hidden Power Ice. Let's go Bulldoze. And Drapion doesn't have the best special bulk. So I'm guessing he won't want to stay in. If he wants to stay in an Earthquake, that's fine. I can Revenge Kill. Okay, he does withdraw. Go into Arcanine, not into Dracula. Sweet! The plays! I mean, it won't do much because he will get Intimidate off and it's not Stab and everything. I mean, it's Expert Belt, so... I mean, a crit would be nice. Nice, and Bulldoze Raikou. Now I can reveal I'm not Choice to him. So, what will he do? He might go for like a Flare Blitz or something. So this is now a turn where I can go straight back into Empoleon and click Fire, click Thingy again. So now he might even go for Morning Sun. Might even go for Morning Sun. No, because Scald will kill. Or do a lot anyway. He made his mind up really quick. Flare Blitz. That's neutral. Let's see how much this does to Empoleon. Oh my god, are you serious? So he has two choices here. He lets me go of rocks. I'm sure he'll switch. He might actually just stay in and Flare Blitz again, which is actually fine for me, I think. I mean, he might actually expect me to switch out into a Cress here. So I'm just going to go for Stealth Rock. Obviously, he can't make a safe switch into Gliscor. Why have I got so many goddamn Skype notifications? Jesus Christ. Right, let's get another Stealth Rock up. He does withdraw, which is cool. Ice, ice. So here comes Kyurem. Now, it's interesting, because what he'll have to do here is go for Earth Power, and I don't know if he's choiced or what at the moment. And if he's not Specs, I might be able to take one. So, do I click Flash Cannon? Do I click Roar? Let's click Flash Cannon. If he subs up, I'm going to be annoyed because I could have clicked Roar and that would be another easy. That's 50% done because when he switches into Earth Power, there it is. Could have made the switch into Cress. Oh, I live on one. Oh, nice. Flash Cannon. Jeez, that done a lot of damage. Thing is, I don't know if he's Scarf or not. We'll now find out if he's Choice or if he's Expert Belt. Because I can go into Cress now. With the Levitate. I can click Moonblast, but I honestly don't know if I want to go and do that just yet. He's got to switch into Entei. Not into Entei. He's got to switch into Drapion here, right? Will they switch into Gliscor? Click Ice Beam. He withdraws, so he's choiced. Nice to know. So there's the Drapion. Can I get the freeze? That 10% freeze hacks would be lovely about now, please. Nope, apparently not. Right, he might go for an earthquake, expecting him to switch again. So I'm gonna stay in and I'm gonna go for the ice beam again, because Moonblast is neutral and ice beam's got a higher special, higher base special. No, they both are the same. All Moonblast has is the same, or to the chance to lower special attack. So if I can get a crit ice beam, that'd be lovely. Does sub. Which is fine. Oh no, he'll have battle armor, so I can't crit. Right, so he stays behind the sub, which is fine. So if he wants to go for a knockoff or an X-Scissor here, that's fine. He should be too weak to set up a sub after the next turn, which then lets me have a free switch in. So we'll see what he wants to do. I'm sure he'll probably Swords Dance here. So I'm going to Ice Beam again. There's a Swords Dance. So he's got Swords Dance, sub, earthquake. So I'm sure all he'll have for this is knockoff. Ice Beam Breaker sub. That's fine. Now, it's about me wanting to try and sack off Raikou potentially. Oh no, wait, is Raikou... Okay, Raikou's not dead. Let's go into Raikou. If he wants to sub, it's fine. I'll just Thunderbolt again. Or even Bulldoze, you know. I need to keep this thing around for Mega Charm. Or knock off, I dare you. Crunch. Ah, okay. Can I live? I doubt it. Okay. Free switch into Vice City. Free switch into lots of things, actually. I swear, Spoonmon. I swear. Do not miss this. I swear to God, if you miss. He's really thinking about it now. He's 6-4 up, but he has got a very weak Arcanine. He has to get rid of the rocks if he wants to use it. This thing is nearly gone. Kyurem is weakened. So is Medicham. So it's all going to come down as to actually whether I can clean up or not. And like I said, keeping Cress healthy is important. So important. I swear, if I miss this Focus Blast, it's going to be game over. I could have gone into Terrakion and clicked Close Combat, but that's just a free switch into his Gliscor, which I don't want him to have. Honestly. Right, he stays in. Please. I've seen his whole moveset. All I have to do is hit this Focus Blast and it's dead. I trace his battle armor, so obviously there's no crits. Yes, we hit! Thank you, Zam! Thank you so much. Thing is, I don't have anything to check Kyurem anymore. Teensy problem. However, he has to get rocks still. He has to get rid of rocks first. And if he specs, actually, that works out even better. Because my Scarfer would be dead, because Raikou was my Scarfer. But the fact he's let Drapion go, when I still have my two Psychic types about, is brilliant. When he has Arcanine in the red, Gliscor... Is that full health? I think Kyurem's will be in red after rocks. Megacham will be orange after rocks. He's got to really play it right. He's going to run out of time eventually as well. I'm really surprised he sacked that off. I'm really surprised. 20 minutes in, it's 5-4. Plus, I can toxic everything now. Which works well for me. Really well. I do actually have knockoff on this Megazam as well. Fisticuffs. See, I think I can kill this thing with a psychic. It's just that I'll take horrible damage from fake out. He hasn't got any nice switches into Cress anymore, so I'm just going to go into Cress. It's the safe play. He didn't... I am going to be faster, so he might have switched, actually. He should have pulled the double here if he's smart. He fakes out. Okay. That's fine. If it comes down to just... If I have Zam at full health, I'm confident I can live a fake out with ease. Even though Cress is like a defensive monster. I'm going to click Toxic, because I can. If he wants to switch an Arcanine, it dies to rocks. If I can Toxic his Gliscor, that's even better. But he knows I have Ice Beam, so if I can just get this off. Who's the most expendable member I have? At this stage, it's probably Terrakion, because I die to a Bullet Punch. But I do have Quick Attack. Which will actually be very helpful, which actually means I have to keep it in case he is Scarf Chiron. Which I honestly thought to myself for the battle he would bring. Because Scarfers are spooky. Now he has to think. He could go into the Rotom Trick as well, which is spooky. And if he does, I will go out into Durant. No, Zam, no. Not Zam. He's really thinking. I've clicked my move. Thing is, three out of my four mana are at full health. Or, including Cress. His are weakened. Two of them are. But he has got Rotom and Gliscor at full, who can't outstall Cress. They just can't outstall Cress. They just can't. No way. Cress is the monster. Drain Punch. He stays in. Okay. Not pulling any doubles or anything, mate. I don't need to play risky at this point. I actually can't let anything else die if I want to finish above Sly. So this thing's poison now, which is fine. Now, will he have a cleric? I don't think so. I'm going to click Moonblast this turn, and I can Moonlight. If he stays in, I can Moonblast. Facade. Ooh. Oh shit, that might actually be a 2-hit KO. Ooh, he might die to poison. Die to poison. That's a really interesting move to have. Oh, he dies to poison, thank God. Did not think of that, did we? Now, what's he going to bring in? Probably Chiron. Yes, Chiron. Now. What's he got left? Gliscor. Right, Chiron is alive. Drapion is alive. Is dead. Megacham is dead. So it's Arcanine, Rotom, Chiron, and Gliscor. Honestly, the ant is the one that's going to have to die, I'm afraid. If I can get in on Arcanine, or he goes to the Draco. He drops the hottest Draco of the century. Oh, we actually live. So if he is I'm going to go for Aerial Ace. We can see... I actually have Protect on this. So I could scout it. I'm going to click Aerial Ace. He withdraws. Ooh. That was... Okay. That's fine by me. Well, he will now defog. He will definitely now defog. So, Vice City. This is where I need you to be, Hax God Fufu. Ironhead Flinch, come through. Please flinch. Please, for the love of God. I know I can't rely on Hax, but... Defog. He does defog, but it... Oh, it failed! Oh, that's a game changer! That is a real game changer! That... Oh my. What does he have left? Arcanine, Kyurem, Gliscor, and Rotom. I think that might have just won me the game. He has to sack Arcanine or Kyurem right now. No! No, 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 no. My life comb, no! We'll try and be right back. I will try and be right back. Please come back. Baby, talk to me. Bloom Boy. I mean, Psychic could kill here. Oh, he lives. I'm gonna Psychic again. Sucker Punch, Rotom, why not? If that kills, I'll be mad. Oh my God, it kills. It actually killed. So, there's only one thing we can do, and that's click Ice Beam. In case he wants to switch, predicting me to go for Moonlight. Right, we are back. The life comm is back. Nothing happened when it was dead. I do have Quick Attack. And does it... Oh, he has Sucker Punch. It won't do much. He sucker punches, okay. That's won him the game, pretty much. I should have moonlighted. Should have clicked Moonlight. If he brings in Gliscor now, which he has to do, he can try and kill me off. He has to defog. So I can get a free... Ice Beam. No. Moonlight. Moonlight is definitely the move I need to make. Moonlight is the play I need to make. Oh God, this is tense. Sucker Punch. Why? Why did I not switch into... Zam was more useful than Crest was at this point. Comes to ice. It dies to rocks. That was silly. He should have gone into Gliscor. I'm pretty sure I'm in a range where close combat will kill Gliscor. These rocks, man. Empoleon coming through. Dracula. And I will outspeed the Arcanine. So I'm going to click Ice Beam. Goes for the knockoff. Oh, we die. So, all comes down as to whether close combat will kill. Let's go to the calcs, see what happens. I swear, if his Arcanine has E-Speed. Let's go to Terrakion. Are you about to get your... How much does Terrakion do? I want to say it does about 40%. Close combat does 29 to 34%. That's got to be a KO range. Die. Die. Yes, come on. Rocks are up. We win. We get the 1-0. Sly, it's not, I don't want it to be a cliche, because it's the last game. But this is the best match of the PPL I have had. Dude, that was such an awesome game. Oh my lord. Oh my god, I enjoy- oh my god, that was- oh. I enjoyed that so much. Whew. The plays were good. We got a two win streak to end the season off. We don't finish above Sly because we didn't get the 4-0, so it's fine. But guys, we won! That was like one of the best game, no, the best game I have been involved in the PPL so far. If you guys did enjoy this match, let alone the season, leave a thumbs up, guys, because. Yeah, I mean, I'm looking at Skype now. Sly wasn't really paying attention when he bought in the Kyrim. That cost him the game, that switch. That really did. Anyway, sorry guys, I'm getting distracted because I'm reading stuff. Yeah, leave a thumbs up if you really enjoyed the season and this match. This match is really worth it. Sorry it cut out. My, the 3DS the software just sort of decided not to respond, but just restarted and it worked, so you didn't really miss much. Anyway guys, make sure you leave a thumbs up, comment please on how you found the season, how this match was, how everything was, and I look forward to seeing you all next season. Bye.